So do you think that Say Cheese is I mean, Vlad is big, man. Vlad them is boys young. Up in California. And how was it going on that show?
Oh, I love Vlad. I study Vlad, if you could tell.
Oh, I could tell.
Yeah, I study Vlad. I stole a lot of his juice. I mean, well, not juice, because he's doing his thing, but I stole his blueprint.
But did you feel like when you went to see it, did it, before, you know, when you went on it, was it the same as you thought it would be?
Nah. I was like, nah.
That's a good
question. But yeah, I study Vlad, and Vlad take from me too. He take my guests.
Yeah, I know.
He take my guests.
I seen. You know, I'm talking about you putting that boy on.
But I love it because I want to do interviews with people, and then the next step is Vlad. It's always like I look at life as a family tree. If I could put you in position to grow, why not?
Yeah. Well, how did you feel when they said that he was a culture vulture?
Vlad's been doing a lot of grinding for years.
Okay.
Passing out CDs.
Respect.
He's not one of them Jews who are, you know, had a little money and tried to get in. Vlad is a part of the culture.
Okay.
I don't agree with a lot of things he says, but who does?
You can't agree with everything everybody says. Yeah. And even if you like don't agree with him, I mean, you can agree to disagree. It's nothing
facts.
Wrong with that.
And I wasn't mad when Vlad brought Charleston White up. Because a lot of people was like, man, you, nah. Because one thing about Charleston White, he still hit me up and check on me. Yo, you good? Listen, how you feeling? We don't talk about interviews or nothing. We just be like, yeah, you can small talk. Yeah. Like, yo, you good? Good.
Yeah.
So I don't feel no type of way. But, you know, Vlad, he watches Say Cheese because he see who doing their thing and he bring them on his show.
Yeah.
And I'm like, cool. I'm like, man, I did that. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I mean, you came from nothing, bro.
Facts.
So you got to realize that's not something that happens every day.
Exactly.
So, and for you to be business savvy enough to keep it going.
Exactly.
As long as you have, that's, I applaud you, brother.
Right.
Because I know what it is to stay in business like that. You got to be focused like ever.
Yep.
What you think?
Competitors and all types of stuff.
Yeah. Everybody talking down. And then some people who do, you think they got your best interest. You don't know if they really, really real with what they're doing.
Yeah.
Yeah. You got to be smart. You got to believe in God too. Yeah. I don't care what you say. God got to be somewhere in there. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Being real, man.
No, facts.
Because you can't do this stuff and stay sane. Well, how do you feel about all the people that's popping up? Because you paid away for a lot of this that's going on.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that? Do you like what you're seeing? Or you think, as far as the interviews, the bloggers, I look at paying homage, you know, I'd be like, okay, how do you feel about it? How do you think it's going from an oval perspective?
I love it.
I'm an OG. My OG, nigga. Yeah, you OG to me now.
Yeah, nah, I see, I love the blog stuff. I see it's paying a lot of bills for people.
Okay.
You
paying no damn bills for us.
Not yet.
It'll get there.
I ain't tripping though. We good over here. That's why I don't charge. Vlad ain't the only nigga don't charge for videos. You know what I'm talking about? I have never charged anyone.
Yeah, I stopped
it only
doing
been
that.
By 4 months. You know
I stopped doing that 3 years ago too. I don't take money for interviews.
Yeah, I don't do it. I've had offers happen. We had a lot of people in our DM, and it's going fast. So I just don't even pay no attention.
But you're very specific about who you bring on to your platform. Am I correct?
Yes. I want to just know with Charleston White. Like Charleston White was already doing this thing. But I just knew that my audience that are like kids, they will react to what he said. So I feel like I just go for people who I think could bring a reaction to my YouTube channel. And that's just that. Like, you don't have to have a million views. I just feel like if I can get you to say the right thing and have a crazy title, we could build off that.
Yeah.
And I didn't even know Charleston White. I just hit him up. I was texting him for like 2-3 days. Is he still
here?
Oh.
Yeah.
You know, he wasn't replying. I'm like, all right, let me find his Facebook because I know he'd be on Facebook.
Oh, he's a funny acting dude. Oh, this dude right here. Oh, I can give you a story, boy. I tell you, you can't get him when he don't want you to get him.
Man, When he feels some type of way, he stand on
you. Oh, yeah, that's what he do.
So he finally texts me back a day later, and you know, he had an Android at the time. He had an Android at the time. So I'm like, damn, okay. Because, you know, with an Android, you can't tell if they read your text messages
correct
or not.
The
so I'm like, damn, does he not like me or something? Like, so we finally got it in, and the interview was where it was at, and then it finally took off when he went in on Gilly the Kid over the little Pop Hunter situation.
Yeah, I remember that.
And then the rest was history. But Charleston White, I love what he stand for.
So would that be, is that your, I ain't going to ask you that, but is
no,
that,
go ahead.
I want to know, is that, is who, You wanted to ask the same question.
Ahead,
you had wrote it down.
Yeah,
who would you say is your most what? Impactful or the one you cherish the most?
Okay, let's do it different. Which interview is your most impactful, highest views? And then also, which interview is your favorite?
It's easy for me. I can reach out to a lot of rappers right now and get a million views. I could text Soulja Boy right now and be like, yo, let's do it. But Charleston White, because he's talking about something. And it may be the truth, it may be the ugly truth, but it's real.
Exactly.
And even some things he's saying, I'd be like, damn, why you say that? Or some things I don't agree with, but I know 5-10 years from now, it's gonna mean something.
Mm-hmm. I don't know, who else, are we the only ones around here that interviewed Charleston? I think we're the only ones.
Both
of us.
At least I got that in common. I can't do nothing else. I done did that with Shug.
No. Dallas Global and Dallas Global for sure.
Yeah.